Students, very good morning. We continue the circus. Now let us see this problem. Right. Show that the circus touch each other and find point of contact. So they said the two circus touch each other. They may touch each other externally. They may touch each other internally. Now let us see that. What is the first circle? What are the C1 R1? C1. Centrally first circle. Divide with 2, change the symbol. 2 comma 3. And what is the R1 equal to? Square root. 4 plus 9 plus 4. That is equal to 5. And what is the C2 R3? Now divide with this 5. What is the circle? X square plus y square. Minus 8 by 5x. Minus 14 by 5y. Minus 32 by 5. Equal to 0. What is the center? C2. Divide with 2, change the symbol. 4 by 5 comma 7 by 4 by 5 comma 7 by 5. What is the R? What is the R? That is equal to square root 16 by 25 plus 14 by 25 plus 32 by 5. 32 by 5. That is equal to square root. Now take the addition from 16 plus 49 plus 5 into 32, 160. See this one, that is equal. Square root 160 plus 40, 209 plus 16, 225. 225 by 25, that equal square root of 9. This is equal to 3. So R2 equal to 3. Right? Now what is the C1 C2? C1 C2 square root 4 by 5 minus 2 whole square plus 7 by 5 minus 3 whole square. That is equal square root 4 minus 10 minus 6 by 5 whole square. That is 36 by 25 plus 7 minus 15 minus 8 by 5. That is 64 by 25. That is equal 100 by 25, that is equal to 4. That is equal to 7 cb is 2. And what is the R1? 5. R2 is 3. What is the mod of R1 minus R2? That is equal to mod of 5 minus 2. That is equal to 2. Right? What is this condition? Therefore, C1 cb equal to mod of R1 minus R2. C1 cb equal to mod of R1 minus R2. Therefore, the two circles touch each other. The two circles touch each other. Circles touch each other internally. Touch each other internally. Touch each other internally. The two circles touch each other internally. What is the meaning? The first circle radius is 5. So this is a big circle. And the second circle is like this. So their two circles touch each other at the point B. C1, C2. C1, C2. And this is the point P. C1, C2. And this is the point P. In what ratio? P divides C1, C2. P divides C1, C2. In the ratio, R1 is to R2. What is the R1 is to R2? 5 is to 3. So P is outside the I segment. C1, C2, what does that mean? P divides C1, C2, P divides C1, C2, in the ratio, R1 is to R2, that is 5 is to 3, externally, so that P is outside the line segment C1, C2, externally. Then what is the P equal to? P equal to, what is that one? P equal to, so 5 into, what is the C1? 2 comma 3. 2 comma 3. And what is the C2? 4 by 5 comma 7 by 5. Right. 5 into 4 by 5. 5 into 4 by 4 minus 3 into 2 by 5 minus 3 comma 5 into 7 by 4 5 into 7 by 4 minus 3 into 3 by 5 minus 3 5 minus 3 5 by 5 cancel 4 minus 6 minus 2 minus 2 by 2 that equal to minus 1 5 by 5 cancel 7 minus 9 minus 2 minus 2 by 2 minus 1 so that is the point of P that is the point of contact right so this is the point of contact minus 1 comma minus 1 so this is the equation of tangent you can find the equation of tangent at the point P that is S1 equal to 0 equation of tangent at P is S1 equal to 0 right that is the equation right right students now see this theorem equation of the chord having P of X1 comma Y1 as its midpoint of the chord S equal to 0 is S1 equal to S11 now see this this is the circle S equal to 0 this is a P P point P of X1 comma Y1 that is the midpoint of the circle AB midpoint of the chord AB midpoint of the chord AB now we have to find the equation of this AB the equation of the chord having P of X1 comma Y1 as its midpoint of the chord. P of X1 comma Y1 is midpoint of the chord. Then this chord equation is S1 equal to S11. Right? This is the center of the circle. CR minus D comma minus A. Now draw this CP. What is the slope of CP? Slope of CP. Slope of CP equal to y1 plus f by x1 plus g and what is the slope of ab? Slope of ab ab equal to what is that one? Minus 1 x1 plus g by y1 plus f and what is the equation of ab? Equation of ab equation of ab y minus y1 equal to minus 1 x1 plus z into by y1 plus y into x minus x1 cross multiply y minus y1 into y1 plus y equal to minus 1 x1 plus z into x minus x1 now cross multiply this y y1 plus f y minus y1 square minus f y1 equal to minus 1 x x1 minus x1 square plus dx minus dx1 what is equal to minus x x1 plus x1 square minus dx plus gx1 and what is y y1 plus f y minus y1 square minus f y1 So this is a positive y y1 plus f. Take this minus to this side plus x x1 minus dx this side plus dx equal to x1 square plus gx1 minus to this side plus y1 square plus this side plus f y1. Now add gx1 plus add gx1 plus f of y1 plus on both sides now what is this one xx1 plus yy1 plus gx plus f gx plus f plus gx1 plus f y1 plus equal to what is this one x1 square plus y1 square plus gx1 plus fy1 plus gx1 fy1 plus, right? Now what is this one? xx1 plus y1 plus g into x plus x1 plus f into y plus y1 plus c equal to x1 square plus y1 square plus 2gx1 plus 2my1 plus c. What is this one? S1 equal to S1. S1 equal to S1. That is the equation of chord having P of x1 comma y1 as its midpoint is S1 equal to S11. So remember this one. So this is a very useful one. Right? Right. Now see this example. Find the midpoint of the chord intersected by the circle on the line. This is the circle S equal to 0. So this is the chord AB. What is the given equation of chord? Chord is x minus 2 plus 7 equal to 0. That is the given chord, and we have to find the, this is the point P of x1 comma y1. This we have to find. We have to find the midpoint of the chord AB to the circle this one on the line x minus 2y plus 7 equal to 0. Right? What is the center of the circle? What is the center? 1 comma 5. And what is the arc radius? 1 plus 25 minus 1. That is equal to this. This center is C of 1 comma 5. C of 1 comma 5. See, this problem we can solve in 2 ways. The equation of the chord having P of x1 comma y1 as its midpoint is S1 equal to S11. Equation of chord. Equation of chord having P of x1 comma y1 as its midpoint, as its midpoint is S1 equal to S11. What is the S1? xx1 plus yy1 minus 7 x plus x1 minus 5 into y plus y1 plus 1 equal to, what is the S11? x1 square plus y1 square minus 2x1 minus 10y1 plus 1. Right? Now in place of x1 y1, xx1 plus yy1 minus x, minus x1, minus 5y, minus 5y1, plus 1. 1, 1 gets cancelled. Take this side. Minus x1 square, minus y1 square, plus 2x1, plus 10y1, equal to 0. Right? Now what is this one? I am going to take x comma, x comma, x1, minus plus take y comma yy1 and this yy1 minus 5 plus what is the constant? Minus x1 minus 5y1 minus x1 minus 5y1 minus x1 square minus y1 square plus 2x1 plus 10y1 equal to 0. What is the difference? Take x down. X1 minus 1 plus y into y1 minus 5 plus. What is the px1 minus x1? X1 minus 5y1 plus 10y1 plus 5y1 minus x1 minus y1 equal to 0. This is the equation 1. But what is the given chord equation? Given chord equation is x minus 2 plus 7 equal to 0. X minus 2 plus 7 equal to 0. That is 2. Both 1 and 2. 1 and 2 represent 1 and 2 represent same line. 1 and 2 is represent same length. What is the difference? X1 minus 1 by what is the exclusion power? Y1 minus 5 by what is the y quotient? Minus 2. That is equal. What is the constant? X1 plus 5y1 minus x1 square minus y1 square power by 7. So the both represent same. Right? Now right, now see this one. Now compare the first and third one. First and second one, and then first and third one. Here I have written first and second one. So just cross multiply. Y1 equal to minus 2x1 plus 7, and then first and third cross multiply. 7x1 minus 7 equal to x1 plus 5y1 minus x1 square minus 4. Take this set. 7x1 minus x1. 6x1 minus 7 minus 5y1 plus x1 square plus y1 square equal to 0. Now put y1 equal to this one. Minus 3x1 plus 7. Substitute that one and factorize. We get x equal to 1 and 7 by 5. Then solve that. If x1 equal to 1, then what is the corresponding y1? Y1 equal to minus 2 into 1 plus 7. 7 minus 2, 5. So 1 comma 5. And y1 equal to, put x1 equal to 7 by 5. Minus 2 into 7 by 5 plus 7. Minus 14 plus 35. 21 by 5. So what is the midpoint of the curve? Either 1 comma 5. But and observe that 1 comma 5, that is not in this equation 1. So 1 comma 25, 1 minus 10 plus 7 equal to 0. 8 minus 10 minus 2 equal to 0. Not possible this one. So this is not possible. So the answer is this one. Right? So the answer is 7 by 5 comma 21 by 5. Right students, understand that the same problem we can do in other way also. This is the P of x1 comma y1. This P point P of x1 comma y1 is the foot of the perpendicular from the center on the line. So you can use the foot of the perpendicular formula, then you can solve that. So that is also one way.